أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط. صدق الله العظيم.
نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم، أما بعد. Now we come to Surah At-Tahrim. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها النبي لما تحرم ما أحل الله لك تبتغي مرضات أزواجك والله غفور رحيم. قد فرض الله لكم تحلة أيمانكم والله مولاكم وهو العليم الحكيم. صدق الله العظيم. You see this last pair of surahs, both are starting with the same words, Ya Ayyuhan Nabi. Surah At-Talaq started, Ya Ayyuhan Nabi, Iza Talaqtumun Nisa Fatalliquhunna Li'iddatihinna. This surah again starting with Ya Ayyuhan Nabi. O Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, why do you ban for yourself what Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala has made lawful to you? You want to seek the pleasure of your wives? And Allah is forgiver, merciful. There's a incident in the background that the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam used to visit every wife, a very short visit, 5 minutes, 10 minutes, between Asr and Maghrib. But it so happened once that to Hazrat Zainab bint Jahash, one of the wives of the Prophet radiallahu anha, some honey came from somewhere. So she used to present that honey to the Prophet when he visited her. And so more time was passing over there than the routine. So this was hard on Hazrat Aisha and Hazrat Hafsa radiallahu ta'ala anhuma. So they decided that when the Prophet comes to us, we shall say that from your mouth the smell of maghafir is coming. Maghafir was some, you know, plant which had some disagreeable smell. But the bee, honey bee, if it had sucked the flowers of maghafir, then in the honey also the smell comes. So they did this. So Prophet, you know, he said, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, I will never take it again. So on this Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying it's not correct. You have committed a mistake. لَمَا تُحَرِّمُ مَا أَحَلَّ اللَّهُ لَكَ. That was permissible for you, halal for you. So why do you ban on yourself the use of something which is permissible, which is halal? Only to please your wives? The Prophet was very lenient, very lenient, very lenient to the wives, no doubt. He says, خَيْرُكُمْ خَيْرُكُمْ لِأَهْلِكُمْ وَأَنَا خَيْرُ خَيْرُكُمْ لِأَهْلِي. Best among you are those who are good to their families. And I am best of you for my families. قَدْ فَرَضُ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ تَحَلَّتْ عَيْمَانِكُمْ. Allah has indeed ordained for you the dissolution of your oaths. If you take an oath, but you want now to dissolve it, there is a way, and we have read it. There is a kafara mentioned in Surah Al-Ma'idah. وَاللَّهُ مَعْلَاكُمْ وَهُوَ الْعَلِيمُ الْحَكِيمُ. And Allah is your protector and He is the knower, the wise. It means you finish your oath and you give the kafara. And another incident, وَإِذْ أَسَرَّ النَّبِيُّ إِلَىٰ بَعْضِ أَزْوَاجِهِ حَدِيثًا. And recall when the Prophet confided to one of his wives a certain matter as a secret. فَلَمَّا نَبَّعَتْ بِهِ. When she disclosed it to another wife, it was probably Hazrat Aisha who disclosed that secret to Hazrat Hafsa رضي الله تعالى عنهما. فلما نبات به واظهر الله. So when she disclosed it, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala informed the messenger of Allah about this. عَرَّفَ بَعْضَهُ وَعَرَضًا بَعْضٍ. So he disclosed that to him, he made known to her a part of it and passed over the other part. فَلَمَّا نَبَّأَهَا بِهِ. So when he informed her of it, she said, مَنْ أَنْبَأَكَ هَذَا. Who informed you of it? قَالَ نَبَّأَنِيُ الْعَلِيمُ الْخَبِيرُ. He said, the knower, the awareer, informed me. That is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is a tone of displeasure and anger in it. Now here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is addressing those two wives of the Prophet, Hazrat Aisha and Hazrat Hafsa radiallahu ta'ala anhuma. إِن تَتُوبَا إِلَى اللَّهِ فَقَدْ سَغَتْ قُلُوبُكُمَا. If you two turn towards Allah repentant, your hearts are indeed so inclined. وَإِنْتَذَارَ عَلَيْهِ. But if you support one another against him, against the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ مَوْلَاهُ. So listen, verily Allah is protector, وَجِبْرِيلُ, and all, after him Jibreel, وَصَالِحُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ, and you know all the righteous believers, وَالْمَلَائِكَةُ بَعْدَ ذَلِكَ زَهِيرٌ, and after that, all the angels are also helpers of our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Asa Rabbuhu, another threat. It may be that in tallaqakunna, if our Prophet divorces you all, and yubdilahu azwajan khairam min kunna, so Lord will give him in exchange wives better than you. Muslimatin, submissive. Muminatin, believing. Qanitatin, obedient. Taibatin, penitent. Abidatin, devout. Abidatin, saihatin, given to fasting. Sayyibatin wa abkara, previously married or virgins. These five ayats, you know, they have a background of the family life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the lesson is that although one should be lenient to the family, but the boundaries of the Sharia, they have to kept intact. Now it was not possible for us, you know, it's possible that we make something which is haram, halal for us, for the sake of our wives or our children. But it was not possible for the Prophet that he can take something which is haram. But he did the other way. That thing that was halal, he put a ban on himself that he will not use it. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took it and gave this guidance for all the ummah. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا قُوْ أَنفُسَكُمْ وَأَهْلِيكُمْ نَارًا. O you who believe, try to save yourselves and your families from the fire. Now this is the positive role that a mu'min believer has to play in his family. The negative was, guard yourself, lest their love takes you in the wrong direction. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِنَّ مِنْ أَزْوَاجِكُمْ وَأَوْلَادِكُمْ عَدُوًّا لَكُمْ فَحَذَرُوهُمْ. Guard yourself. Be on the alert. But the positive role is that you have to try to save them from the fire of hell. Try to bring them to the way of Allah. Try to bring them up in the best Islamic, you know, way, so that they are saved on the day of judgment from the fire of hell. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا قُوْ أَنفُسَكُمْ وَأَهْلِيكُمْ نَارًا وَقُودُهَا النَّاسُ وَالْحِجَارَةُ. The fuel of that fire is to be mankind and stones. Stones, they are idols which they used to do worship. They will also be thrown with them into the fire of the hell. عَلَيْهَا مَلَائِكَةٌ غِلَاظٌ شِدَادٌ. Over that are appointed angels who are very stern and very strong. لَا يَعْصُونَ اللَّهُ مَا أَمَرَهُمْ. They never disobey Allah. Whatever Allah commands them, يَفْعَلُونَ مَا يُمَرُونَ. They do whatever they are commanded to do. What does it mean? You love your children, but due to excessive love, these children are going on wrong ways. If they are going on wrong ways, what does it mean? They are going to the fire of hell. Now when these beloved ones of you, they'll be thrown in the fire of hell. And you know, the angels will be there. They will never, their hearts will never melt on their weeping and crying and mourning and groaning. They are very stern. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says they have to be chastised, they will chastise. Ya ayyuha alladhina kafaru la ta'tadiru al-yawm. And it will be said to the disbelievers, O you who disbelieved, la ta'tadiru al-yawm, do not excuse yourself this day. Innama tujzawna ma kuntum ta'malun. You are only being recompensed for what you used to do. Now comes a very beautiful ayah of the Quran addressing the Muslims. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu tubu ila Allahi tawbatan nasuha. O you who believe or profess to believe, repent to Allah, turn to Allah in sincere repentance, tawbatan nasuha, pure and sincere repentance. Asa rabbukum an yukaffira ankum sayyi'atikum. Maybe that your Lord will acquit you and expunge from your record your evil deeds. وَيُدْخِلَكُمْ جَنَّاتٍ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارُ. And make you enter the gardens underneath which rivers will be flowing. يَوْمَ لَا يُخْزِي اللَّهُ النَّبِيَّ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مَعَهُ. The day when Allah will not humiliate the Prophet and those who believed with him. نُورُهُمْ يَسْعَى بَيْنَ أَيْدِيهِمْ. Now the same picture which we found in Surah Al-Hadid. يَوْمَ تَرَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتِ نُورُهُمْ يَسْعَى بَيْنَ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَبِأَيْمَانِهِمْ بُشْرَاكُمُ الْيَوْمَ جَنَّاتٌ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارُ. The same picture here. نُورُهُمْ يَسْعَى بَيْنَ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَبِأَيْمَانِهِمْ. Their light will be running in front of them and on their right hand side. يَقُولُونَ. And they will be saying, رَبَّنَا أَتْمِمْ لَنَا نُورَنَا. O our Lord, complete and perfect our light for us. وَغْفِرْ لَنَا. And forgive us. إِنَّكَ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ. Verily, you are powerful over everything. Now what does this mean? Actually, the noor of Iman will be according to the intensity of Iman. Somebody had very intense Iman, so light will be very strong. Others had Iman in their heart, but not so intense. So the light will be low. In this way, varying degrees of lights. The Prophet had said, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, on that day, some people will be given a light which will enlighten from Medina to Sana'a. Up to Sana'a, Yemen, this light will go. And there will be others whose light will only lighten the place before their feet, just like the light of a torch. It has a very small area, but you see the way. You are saved. So this is the variation. So those whose light will be not very strong, they will then pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, O Allah, our light is not so strong, why? We had not so intense iman, we didn't have many so many good deeds. So this thing you can perfect our life by your own authority. So Rabbana atmim lana nurana. O Allah, make our light perfect, waqfir lana. And because it is not perfect due to our sins, so forgive us our sins. Innaka ala kulli shay'in qadeer. Verily, you have power over everything. Ya ayyuhan nabiyyu jahidil kuffara wal munafiqeena waghluz alayhim. O Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, struggle hard against the disbelievers and the hypocrites, and be you harsh with them. Your leniency, you know, shouldn't be for the hypocrites. Leniency for the believers. But for the hypocrites and the kuffar, you have to be harsh. Mawahum jahannam wa besal masir. Their abode is hell and it is an evil destination. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving here four examples of women. Generally, the idea among women folk is that actually the religion addresses only men. We are under men, so as if we are attached to our men. If they are doing good deeds, it's okay. We shall also benefit from their good deeds. Quran says, no, every soul, male or female, has to work for himself or herself. And there can be that the husband might be a very good person, but the wife might be going to Jahannam. Or the husband might be a very big enemy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the wife might be a very righteous, you know, servant of Allah. This is just possible. So every human soul, male or female, is independent of others, regarding his own virtues, his own iman, his or her iman, his or her deeds. Now, as for the kafir women, ضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا لِلَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا امْرَأَةَ نُوحٍ وَامْرَأَةَ لُوطٍ. Allah has struck a similitude for those who disbelieve, the wife of Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam and the wife of Lut alayhi salatu wasalam. كَانَتَا تَحْتَ عَبْدَيْنِ مِنْ عِبَادِنَا صَالِحَيْنِ. Both of them were under our two very righteous servants, messengers of Allah, Nuh and Lut, and they were in their homes, wives. فَخَانَتَاهُمَا. But they betrayed them. فَلَمْ يُغْنِيَا عَنْهُمَا مِنَ اللَّهِ شَيْعَا. So they and their husbands availed them nothing whatsoever against Allah. وَقِيلَ دْخَلَ النَّارَ مَعَ الدَّاخِلِينَ. And it was said to them, enter the fire along with the enterers. Although they were wives of two messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam himself used to gather the women folk, close relatives. Then he should address each one by name. Ya Fatimatu bintu Rasulillah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, anqazi nafsaka minan nar, fa inni la amliku laki minallahi shay'a. O Fatima, the dear daughter of the Messenger of Allah, you have to save yourself from the fire of hell. I will not have any authority about you on the Day of Judgment. Ya Safiyatu ammatu Rasulillah, anqazi nafsaka minan nar, fa inni la amliku laki minallahi shay'a. O Safiya, the maternal aunt, the paternal aunt of the Messenger of Allah, you have to take out yourself from the fire, save yourself from the fire. I will not have any power, ever authority about you on the Day of Judgment. So every human soul is independent and responsible for his or her deeds. Conversely, there is the example of the wife of Fir'aun, Asiya. The name is not given in Quran, it is in Torah. وَضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا امْرَأَةَ فِرْعَوْنَ. And Allah has struck a similitude for those who believe, the wife of Fir'aun, when she said this, قَالَتْ رَبِّ ابْنِ لِي إِنْدَكَ بَيْتًا فِي الْجَنَّةِ. O my Lord, build for me a house in the garden in thy presence, near you. وَنَجَّنِي مِنْ فِرْعَوْنَ. And deliver me from Fir'aun, وَعَمَلِهِ and his doings. وَنَجَّنِي مِنَ الْقَوْمِ الظَّالِمِينَ. And deliver me from the evil-doing people. Now she was living in a palace, wife of the emperor Fir'aun. But she had a different way. As we know, she was an Israelite, and you know, she was taken to the palace, and the emperor took her as wife, and she reared Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. She was so righteous and pious woman, but she was not happy with Fir'aun and the attitude and what Fir'aun was doing. So this is the example absolutely opposite. There the two messengers of Allah, Nuh and Lut, and wives, going to the hell. Here Fir'aun, who is going to the hell, but the wife Asiya was a very righteous woman. Now the fourth example. وَمَرْيَمَ ابْنَةَ عِمْرَانَ الَّتِي أَحْسَنَتْ فَرْجَهَا. And the similitude of Maryam, daughter of Imran, who guarded her chastity. So, فَنَفَغْنَا فِيهِ مِنْ رُوحِنَا. We breathed into her our spirit. وَصَدَّقَتْ بِكَلِمَاتِ رَبِّهَا. And she testified to the truth of the words of the Lord. وَكُتُبِهِ and his books. وَكَانَتْ مِنَ الْقَانِتِينَ. And she was a very devout woman. Now this is the example where the woman or the girl herself was very pious. And she was in the custody of a very pious person, Zakariya alayhi salatu wasalam. So this is Nurul Ala Nur. Now there is one corner is vacant here. Worst women in the homes of the best people, wife of Lut, wife of Nuh. Best woman in the house of worst man, Asiya. Best girl or woman and under the custody of a very pious and good man, that is Zakariya, she is Maryam. Now the worst woman in the home of the worst man, that fourth position is vacant. But that is filled in Quran, in the last part, in Suratul Tabbat Yada Abi Lahab. Abu Lahab, worst enemy of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and his wife Umm Jamil, also the worst enemy. We can't say which one of them was more, you know, bigger enemy to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam than the other. So that is, this is Nurul Ala Nur, Maryam, and that is Zulumatun, Ba'duha Fawqa Ba'd, and that is Umm Jamil and her husband Abu Lahab. Now here we end with the group of 10 Madani surahs. This was the 6th Makki Madani group which ends here. Now the last and the 7th Madani Makki group starts with Suratul Mulk. And this is mostly Makki, two parts of the Quran. Most of it is Makki. A very few surahs in the end you will find Madani. Just the converse of the first group. One surah, Suratul Fatiha, Makki, and 6 parts, Suratul Baqarah, Ali Imran, An-Nisa, Maida, Madaniyat. So it's the converse here. Now mostly this group is occupied by the Makki surahs and very few, very little Madani surahs. And here also, as it was in the 3rd group of the Makki surahs, there are subgroups of 3 surahs. One solitary, 2 in a pair. Suratul Mulk is solitary. Then Surah Noon and Surah Haqqa will come as a pair. And so on, we shall see. Suratul Mulk, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Tabarakal Ladhi biyadihil Mulk wa huwa ala kulli shayin qadir. Blessed is he in whose hand is the sovereignty. Mulk. Wa huwa ala kulli shayin qadir. And he has power over everything. الَّذِي خَلَقَ الْمَوْتَ وَالْحَيَاةَ لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا. Who created the death and life to try you, which of you is best in conduct. وَهُوَ الْغَفُورُ الْعَزِيزُ الْغَفُورُ. And he is the mighty, the forgiving. Now you see here, creation of death is mentioned first, and then of life. Normally if you think, life should be mentioned first, and then death. Here, death first and life later. Why? We have already passed that first death when we were created in the form of the spirits. And then first death overtook us. And then we were revived when we came in this world, in the wombs of our mothers. Then our ruh was blown into us. So actually, death has preceded life. One death we have already gone through. The other death we are waiting for, that is coming to us. خَلَقَ الْمَوْتَ وَالْحَيَاةَ لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيَّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا. Allama Iqbal has translated it, so to say, in a very beautiful couplet. قُلْزُمِ هَسْتِي سَ تُو عُبْرَاهِ مَانِنْدِ حَبَاب اِسْ زِيَانْ خَانِ مِنْ تَيْرَا اِمْتِحَانْ هَي زِندَگِي. It's a period of testing. الَّذِي خَلَقَ سَبْعَ سَمَاوَاتٍ طِبَاقًا. He who created the 7 heavens, one above the other. مَا تَرَى فِي خَلْقِ الرَّحْمَانِ مِنْ تَفَاوُرٍ. You will not see in the creation of the compassionate any disparity or any flaws. فَرْجِعِ الْبَصَرَ هَلْ تَرَى مِنْ فُطُورٍ. So extend your gaze. Look, do you find any flaw? سُمَّرْجِعِ الْبَصَرَ كَرَّتَيْنِ. Then return your gaze again and again, and yet your gaze will come back to you. ينقلب إليك البصر خاسئا وهو حسير. It will be humiliated and tired, but it will not be able to point out any flaw in the creation of the heavens. It's so complete a phenomenon, so complete a creation. ثم ارجع البصر كرتين ينقلب إليك البصر خاسئا وهو حسير. ولقد زينا السماء الدنيا بمصابيح. And we have adorned the lowest heaven with lamps. وَجَعَلْنَاهَا رُجُومًا لِلشَّيَاطِينَ. And we have made them as missiles for pelting shaitans. وَعَتَدْنَا لَهُمْ عَذَابَ السَّعِيرِ. And we have prepared for them the chastisement of the blazing fire. وَلِلَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا بِرَبِّهِمْ عَذَابُ جَهَنَّمَ. As for those who disbelieve in their Lord, for them is the chastisement of the hell. وَبِئْسَ الْمَصِيرُ, and it's a very evil destination. إِذَا أُلْقُوا فِيهَا, when they will be thrown into it, سَمِعُوا لَهَا شَهِيقًا, they will hear it roaring with a terrible drawing in of the breath, taking into the breath with the roar. وَهِيَ تَفُورُ, and it will be blazing forth. تَكَادُ تَمَيَّزُ مِنَ الْغَيْسِ, it will be as if it will burst with rage. كُلَّمَا أُلْقِيَ فِيهَا فَوْجٌ, whenever a group will be cast into it, سَأَلَهُمْ خَزَنَتُهَا, so the keepers of hell will ask them, أَلَمْ يَأْتِكُمْ نَزِيرٌ, did not a warner come to you? قَالُوا بَلَىٰ قَدْ جَاءَنَا نَزِيرٌ, they will say, why not? A warner did come to us. فَكَذَّبْنَا, we belied him. وَقُلْنَا مَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ مِنْ شَيْءٍ, we said, Allah has not sent down anything. إِنْ أَنْتُمْ إِلَّا فِي ضَلَالٍ كَبِيرٍ, you are surely in a great error. You are gravely mistaken. وَقَالُوا لَوْ كُنَّا نَسْمَعُ وَنَعْقِلُ, they said, had we listened attentively, أَوْ نَعْقِلْ, or we had tried to understand, مَا كُنَّا فِي أَصْحَابِ السَّعِيرِ, we would not have been the dwellers of this hellfire. فَاعْتَرَفُوا بِذُنُوبِهِمْ, so they will confess their sin, their shortcoming. فَسَوْقَ لِأَصْحَابِ السَّعِيرِ, so let the people of the fire be taken or driven away. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَخْشَوْنَ رَبَّهُمْ بِالْغَيْبِ, on the contrary, those who kept fearing their Lord in the unseen, لَهُمْ مَغْفِرَةٌ وَأَجْرٌ كَبِيرٌ, for them there will be forgiveness and a great reward. وَأَسِرُّوا قَوْلَكُمْ وَاجْهَرُوا بِهِ, whether you conceal your word or proclaim it, إِنَّهُ عَلِيمٌ بِذَاتِ الصُّدُورِ, it's equal to him, because he knows whatever is in your hearts. But to speak of listening to something which you are saying in low voice, or to something which you are saying loudly. أَلَا يَعْلَمُ مَنْ خَلَقْ, will he not know who has created? وَهُوَ لَطِيفُ الْخَبِيرُ, and he is the most subtle and the most aware. هُوَ الَّذِي جَعَلَ لَكُمُ الْأَرْضَ ذَلُولًا, it is he who has made for you the earth submissive. فَمْشُوا فِي مَنَاكِبِهَا, so you walk in its tracks. وَكُلُوا مِنْ رِزْقِهِ, and you eat from its food, whatever it gives you. وَكُلُوا مِنْ رِزْقِهِ وَإِلَيْهِ النُّشُورِ, and to him, to Allah, will be your resurrection. أَأَمِنْتُمْ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاءِ يَخْسِفَ بِكُمُ الْأَرْضَ فَإِذَا هِيَ تَمُورُ, do you feel secure, you don't fear your Lord who is in the heaven, that he will not cause the earth to swallow you up while it shakes in earthquakes? أَأَمِنْتُمْ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاءِ يُرْسِلَ عَلَيْكُمْ حَاسِبًا, or are you absolutely secure that he who is in the heaven will not set against you a stone storm? فَسَتَعْلَمُونَ كَيْفَ نَزِيرٌ, then you shall come to know how terrible was my warning. وَلَقَدْ كَذَّبَ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ, and surely those also who were before them belied and rejected. فَكَيْفَ كَانَ النَّكِيرُ, so how was my punishment? أَوَلَمْ يَرَوْا يَطَّيْرِ فَوْقَهُمْ صَافَّاتٍ وَيَقْبِضْنَ, don't they see the birds above them? They sometimes spread out their wings and other times close them. مَا يُمْسِكُهُنَّ إِلَّا الرَّحْمَانُ, none can uphold them save the compassionate. إِنَّهُ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ بَصِيرٌ, surely he is seer of everything. أَمَّنْ هَذَا الَّذِي هُوَ جُنْدٌ لَكُمْ يَنْصُرُكُمْ مِنْ دُونِ الرَّحْمَانِ, إِنِ الْكَافِرُونَ إِلَّا غُرُورٌ, who is that which can be a host or which can be an army for you, to help you, besides the compassionate? If Allah the compassionate wants to do something bad for you, who can help you? Which is the army? إِنِ الْكَافِرُونَ إِلَّا فِي غُرُورٍ, the disbelievers are in nothing but delusion. أَمَّنْ هَذَا الَّذِي يَرْزُقُكُمْ مِنْ أَمْسَكَ رِزْقَهُ, or who is that who can provide you with the sustenance if Allah withholds his sustenance from you? بَلْ لَجُّوا فِي عُتُوٍّ وَنُفُورٍ, nay, they persist in their rebellion and aversion. Afa man yamshi mukibban ala wajhi yahda man yamshi sawiyan ala sirat mustaqim. This is a very important ayah. Is he who goes crawling on his face better guided, or he who walks upright on a straight way? A person is lying on his belly and crawling on the ground. Otherwise, he's standing erect and he has a path before him and going. Who will be more guided? Definitely the one who is erect, seeing what is in front of him, and he has a way, a path which is following. Now, what is the similitude? People who are living only on animal instincts, they have no goal in life, no ideal, then they are living on the bellies. They are crawling, they are not walking. Only a person who has a goal in life, I have to do this, this is my ideal, this is my objective, and this is the path, this is the methodology which I have to follow. He is the person, he is the human being. Otherwise, the others are like animals, crawling on the ground. They have no direction in their lives. They are not living. Life is passing them. They are not passing their lives. Life is passing them actually. Otherwise, a person who has a goal in his life and a methodology before him clear, he is the person who actually can be said to be a human being. قُلْ هُوَ الَّذِي أَنْشَاكُمْ وَجَعَلَ لَكُمُ السَّمْعَ وَالْأَبْصَارَ وَالْأَفْئِدَةَ. Say, He is Allah who has brought you forth and assigned to you hearing and sight and the power of reasoning and inference. قَلِيلًا مَا تَشْكُرُونَ. Little thanks that you give. قُلْ هُوَ الَّذِي ذَرَاكُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَإِلَيْهِ تُوْشَرُونَ. Say, It is He who has scattered you on the earth, and Him, to Him you shall be returned, gathered. وَيَقُولُونَ مَتَى هَذَا الْوَعْدُ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. And they say, when shall this promise be fulfilled if you are truthful? قُلْ إِنَّمَا الْعِلْمُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. Say, the knowledge of that is with Allah alone. وَإِنَّمَا أَنَا نَذِيرٌ مُبِينٌ. As for I am only a plain warner and nothing else. فَلَمَّا رَأَوْهُ زُلْفَةً. But when they will see it near, that Qiyamah, سِيَتْ وُجُوهُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. Then the faces of those who disbelieve will be grieved. وَقِيلَ هَذَا الَّذِي كُنْتُمْ بِهِ تَدَّعُونَ. And then it will be said, this is what you were calling for, what you were demanding. قُلْ أَرَأَيْتُمْ إِنْ أَهْلَكْنِيَ اللَّهُ وَمَنْ مَعِيَّ أَوْ رَحِمَنَا. Say, O Prophet, have you considered? If Allah destroys me and those who are with me, or He has mercy on us, فَمَنْ يُجِيرُ الْكَافِرِينَ مِنْ عَذَابٍ أَلِيمٍ. Who will be able to deliver and protect these disbelievers from a painful chastisement? Whatever comes to me, okay, it will come. But what about you? If the chastisement has come to you, who will save you? قُلْ هُوَ الرَّحْمَانِ آمَنَّا بِهِ. Say, He is the compassionate. We believe in Him. وَعَلَيْهِ تَوَكَّلْنَا. And in Him we have put our trust. فَسَتَعْلَمُونَ مَنْ هُوَ فِي ضَلَالٍ مُبِينٍ. So very soon you will come to know who is in the manifest error. قُلْ أَرَأَيْتُمْ. Say, have you ever considered? إِنْ أَصْبَحَ مَعَوْكُمْ غَوْرًا. If all of your water were to sink down into the earth, فَمَنْ يَعْتِيكُمْ بِمَعِيمْ مَعِينٍ. Then who would be able to bring you the clear gushing water? The water table is, if it is going down, you know, then there is worry. The water in the Lake Galilee is going down, and the Israelites are very worried about it. Suratul Qalam. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. The first 7 or 9 ayat of this surah, and I think 7, are the second wahi to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The first is the 5 first ayat of Suratul Alaq. اقرأ بسم ربك الذي خلق خلق الإنسان من علق. And the second wahi is this. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نون والقلم وما يسطرون. It is starting with one letter, noon. We had already Surah Qaf, Surah Sad. This is the third one. Wal qalami wa ma yasturun, and by the pen and by that which they write. Ma anta bi ni'mati rabbika bi majnun. You, O Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, are not by the blessing of your Lord a madman or a possessed man by demons or crazy. No, nothing of the sort. Now actually this was the first reaction of the people of Makkah. When the first wahi came to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he came and he said, an angel came to me, I was alone in Hira, and this thing happened. So maybe a general reaction, and it was not in enmity, I think. It was simple reaction. Oh, maybe some jinn has possessed him. Maybe it was some delusion, some illusion, some hallucination. What has happened to him? So that was the first reaction. And people started saying, he has gone mad, perhaps. He has lost his mental balance, perhaps. Perhaps he has been possessed by some evil spirit or jinn. But when the prophets heard these things, he was hurt. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is consoling him. No, don't feel hurt. Noon qalam wa ma yasturun. The pen and all this academic record that this pen has collected, it testifies that you, O Muhammad, cannot be a mad person. Nobody can say this. Wa inna laka la ajran ghayra mamnoon. And for you, there is going to be a reward which will be unending. وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَىٰ خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. And surely you are on an extremely sublime character. Can any madman have this type of character which you have, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Actually, these people have gone mad. فَسَتُبْصِرُ وَيُبْصِرُونَ. So very soon, you will also see and they will also see. بِأَيَّكُمُ الْمَفْتُونَ. Who among you was afflicted with madness? Inna rabbaka huwa alamu biman dhalla an sabilihi wa huwa alamu bil muhtadin. Surely your Lord knows best who has gone astray from his way, and he knows best who are rightly guided. Fala, these are the seven ayat. We end here. Fala tuti'il mukazzibin. Now this is later period, these ayat which are being revealed at some later time and joined here. So Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you don't obey or you don't even listen attentively to these people who are belying you. وَدُّوا لَوْ تُدْهِنُوا فَيُدْهِنُونَ. They wish that you should be ready to make a compromise. So that they will also make a compromise. وَلَا تُطِعْ كُلَّ حَلَّافٍ مَهِينٍ. Don't obey the mean swearer. This is Walid bin Mughira or Akhnas bin Quraysh. Hammaz bin Mashaim bin Amin. Defamer, going about with calumnies. Manail lil khair, hinderer of good. Mu'tadin, transgressor, asim, sinful. Utullin, harsh. Ba'da zalika zaneem. And besides all that, of doubtful birth. Ankana za malin wa baneen. Only because he has wealth and sons. إِذَا تُتْلَى عَلَيْهِ آيَاتُنَا قَالَ أَسَاطِرُ الْأَوَّلِينَ. Whenever revelations are recited unto him, he says, fables of the ancients. سَنَسِمُهُ عَلَى الْخُرْطُومِ. We shall put a seal on his prominent nose. إِنَّا بَلَوْنَاهُمْ كَمَا بَلَوْنَا أَصْحَابِ الْجَنَّةِ. Now a story of some people who owned a garden, some brothers. And the garden, you know, the fruit was ready to be plucked. So they made a decision at night that we shall tomorrow go and pluck the fruit. And they didn't say, inshallah. This is story of those people who believe in Allah, who are not mushriks, who believe in Allah. But they are so much overwhelmed with this worldly life that they forget. Forget Allah. And secondly, because they are not keeping Allah's remembrance in their mind, their character goes down. moral values go down. So this is in a form of a parable, this condition of most of the people who live in this world, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given as an example. We have tried them just as we tried the owners of the garden. When they swore that they would certainly pluck its fruit in the morning. And they made no exception. They didn't say, inshallah, no. We shall definitely. Tomorrow we have to go, we have to do it. فَتَعْفَ عَلَيْهَا تَعْفُ مِنْ رَبِّكَ وَهُمْ نَائِمُونَ. Now during the night, a visitation from your Lord visited it, the garden, while they were sleeping. Some hot air blew, and the whole of the garden was burnt. فَأَصْبَحَتْ كَالسَّرِيمِ. So the garden became as if it has already been plucked. فَتَنَادَ مُسْبَيْنَا. There in the garden this has happened. They are at their house. In the morning they are calling each other. Then they called out one to another in the morning. أَلِغْدُوا عَلَىٰ هَرْسَكُمْ إِنْ كُنْتُمْ صَارِمِينَ. If you want really to pluck the fruit, then go early to your farm. فَانْتَلَقُوا. Then they started, departed. وَهُمْ يَتَخَافَتُونَ. And they were saying to each other in low voice, أَلَّا يَدْخُلَنَّهَا الْيَوْمَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِسْكِينَ. Let no needy and poor person enter it today. Why should they come? What right they have? We worked over this garden. We looked after it. We watered it. Now the fruit is ours. But these beggars, these poor men, they gather so that they should also be given something. Why should they get? So see to it that today no beggar, no poor man enters there. Now this is the level of their morality. They have gone down so low. وَغَدَوْ عَلَىٰ عَبْدِ الْقَادِرِينَ. And then they went fully determined in their purpose. فَلَمَّا رَوْهَا. Now when they saw their garden, قَالُوا إِنَّا لَضَالُّونَ. They said, oh, we have forgotten the way, we have come astray. This is not our garden. بَلْ نَحْنُ مَحْرُومُونَ. But then they realized, oh, we have been deprived. قَالَ أَوْسَتُهُمْ أَلَمْ أَقُلْ لَكُمْ لَوْلَا تُصَبِّحُونَ. The middle one, moderate of them said, did I not keep saying to you, why do you not glorify Allah? Why have you forgotten Allah? لَوْلَا تُصَبِّحُونَ. Now they said, قَالُوا سُبْحَانَ رَبِّنَا إِنَّا كُنَّا ظَالِمِينَ. They said, glory to our Lord, surely we were the evildoers. فَأَقْبَلَ بَعْضُمْ عَلَىٰ بَعْضِ يَتَلَابَنُونَ. Then they advanced one against the other, blaming each other. You did it, you did it. You made us forget Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You did that. And for that reason, we forgot Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and so on. And in the end, قَالُوا يَا وَيْلَنَا إِنَّا كُنَّا تَاغِينَ. Woe to us, surely. We were all transgressors. أَسَى رَبُّنَا يُبْدِلَنَا خَيْرًا مِّنْهَا. It may be that our Lord gives us in exchange a better garden than this. Inna ila rabbina raghibun. Surely we are beseechers to our Lord. Now the ayah. This is the lesson, the moral lesson of the story. Kazalikal azab. In this way chastisement comes. Wal azabul akhirat akbar. But the chastisement of the hereafter would be much greater. Law kanu ya'lamun. Only if they had known. Because here, if one harvest is gone, you can hope to have the second harvest. But then in the hereafter, no harvest. No chance more. So that is the chastisement. If you keep it away from your mind, just forget, just leave it. No akhirah. Although they believe in Allah, and they are not mushriks, but forgetful of Allah and low in character. Most of the people belong to this category. إِنَّ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ جَنَّاتِ النَّعِيمِ. Now, contrary to that, verily for those who fear Allah, for them there are the gardens of bliss with their Lord. أَفَنَجْعَلُ الْمُسْلِمِينَ كَالْمُجْرِمِينَ. Shall we then treat those who submit to us in Islam like the guilty? If there is no akhirah, then both become equal. people who are guilty and people who are doing good deeds, they are equal. If there is no akhira, no resurrection, no reward, no punishment. مَا لَكُمْ كَيْفَتْ أَفَنَجْعَلُ الْمُسْلِمِينَ كَالْمُجْرِمِينَ مَا لَكُمْ كَيْفَتْ تَحْكُمُونَ What has happened to you? How do you judge? أَمْ لَكُمْ كِتَابٌ فِيهِ تَدْرُسُونَ Is there a book for you wherein you study? إِنَّ لَكُمْ فِيهِ لَمَا تَخَيَّرُونَ That you shall surely have in the akhira what you choose? أَمْ لَكُمْ أَيْمَانٌ عَلَيْنَا بَالِغَةٌ إِلَى يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ Do they have the oath from us regarding the day of resurrection? Inna lakum lama tahkumun, that you shall have whatever you judge. Salhum, ask him, O Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, ayyuhum bizalika zaim, who can guarantee this? Am lahum shuraka, are there any associates with them? Falyatu bi shurakaihim in kanu sadiqin. If they are truthful, then they should bring their shuraka, those who they associate with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yawma yukshafu an saqin, the day when the shin will be laid bare, shin of Allah. Now we can't say what will be its form. But in the Sahih of Imam Bukhari rahmatullah alayh, there is a hadith from Abu Sa'id Khudri radiallahu anhu, which says it means this, that in the day of judgment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will show to the people some of his grandeur, which he is referring as the shin. And then they will be asked to prostrate before Allah. يَوْمَ يُشْرَفُ عَنْ سَاقٍ وَيُدْعَوْنَ إِلَى السُّجُودِ فَلَا يَسْتَطِعُونَ These unbelievers, disbelievers, will not be able to prostrate at that time. They will try, they will want, but no. It will be made impossible for them. Because in the life before that, in the world, they didn't use to prostrate before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. At that time, what will happen? خَاشْيَةً أَبْصَارُهُمْ Their looks will be downcast. تَرْحَقُهُمْ ذِلَّةِ And humiliation will spread over them. وَقَدْ كَانُوا يُدْعَوْنَ إِلَى السُّجُودِ وَهُمْ سَالِمُونَ And they were used, they were called to prostrate before their Lord when they were healthy and sound. فَذَرْنِي So leave me, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَمَنْ يُكَذِّبُ بِهَذَا الْحَدِيثِ And those who belie this Quran. سَنَسْتَدْرِجُهُمْ مِنْ هَيْسُ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ We shall step by step lead them on whence they know not. We will give them respite and then pull towards Jahannam. Then some respite, then pull. Just as you know, somebody who is fishing, he lets the string go, then he pulls towards him, etc. فَأُمْلِي لَهُمْ إِنَّ كَيْدِي مَتِينَ I will give them respite, but surely my plan is firm. أَمْ تَصَلُهُمْ أَجْلًا فَهُمْ مِنْ مَغْرَمِ مُسْقَلُونَ Do you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ask them for a reward so they are burdened with a debt? أَمْ إِنَّهُمُ الْغَيْبُ فَهُمْ يَكْتُبُونَ Or they have the knowledge of the unseen, and they are writing it down? فَاسْبِرْ لِحُكْمِ رَبِّكَ So wait, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, for the command of your Lord. وَلَا تَكُنْكَ صَاحِبِ الْحُوتِ And don't be like the companion of the fish, Hazrat Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam, who without the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala left his nation. So he was punished. He was swallowed by a fish. And then when he, you know, called Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the belly of that fish, لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنْتَ سُبْحَانَكَ إِنِّي كُنْتُ مِنَ الظَّالِمِينَ Then Allah excused him. And then he was vomited by the fish on the bear's coast. Of as far as I think, Makran. فَاسْبِرْ لِحُكْمِ رَبِّكَ وَلَا تَكُنْكَ صَاحِبِ الْحُوتِ So wait patiently for your Lord's judgment and be not like the companion of the fish. When he cried out while he was in anguish, لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنْتَ سُبْحَانَكَ إِنِّي كُنْتُ مِنَ الظَّالِمِينَ لَوْ لَا أَنْتَ دَارَكَهُ نِعْمَةُ مِنْ رَبِّهِ لَنُبِذَ بِالْعَرَاءِ وَهُوَ مَزْمُونَ Had he not a blessing from his Lord which reached him, he was actually already thrown on a plain ground near the coast. And he was masmoom. He was in disgrace. فَاجْتَبَاهُ رَبَّهُ But later Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala excused him, pardoned him, and he chose him again. who brought him nearer to him. فَجَعَلَهُ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. And then he made him from among the righteous people. وَإِن يَكَادُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا لَيُزْلِقُونَكَ بِأَبْصَارِهِمْ لَمَّا سَمِعُوا الذِّكْرِ. And verily there is those who disbelieve will almost make you slip with their eyes, with their gazes. They used to see Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam with very piercing gazes, piercing eyes. Maybe to kill his will. Or it was also, you know, it did an occult science. So you can overcome somebody's will through this effect through your eyes. So they are doing so. Lamma samya'u zikr. When they are listening to the revelations and the admonition, وَيَقُولُونَ إِنَّهُ لَمَجْنُونَ. And they are saying, but verily he is Majnoon. He has been either possessed by a demon or jinn or some evil spirit, or he has gone mad. فَمَا هُوَ إِلَّا ذِكْرُ لِلْعَالَمِينَ. Whereas the reality is that it is nothing, this Quran is nothing, but an admonition and reminding for all the peoples of the world. Surah Al-Haqqah. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحاقة. That thing which is sure to happen. الحاقة. ما الحاقة. What is that thing which is sure to happen? وما أدراك ما الحاقة. And what will make you realize what is this sure to happen? That is قيامة. Resurrection. The day of resurrection. The day of judgment. كذبت ثمود وعاد بالقارعة. The Samud and Aad both belied the sudden calamity. فَأَمَّا سَمُودُ فَأُولِكُمْ بِالطَّاغِيَةِ. As for the Samud, they were destroyed by the screamer. Awful cry. وَأَمَّا عَادٌ فَأُولِكُمْ بِرِيْهِنْ سَرْسَرِنْ عَاتِيَةِ. And as for the Aad, they were destroyed by a roaring violent wind. سَخَّرَهَا عَلَيْهِمْ سَبْعَ لِيَالٍ وَثَمَانِيَةَ أَيَّامٍ حُسُومًا. Allah imposed upon them for 7 nights and 8 days in succession. فَتَرَى الْقَوْمَ فِيهَا سَرْعَى. So that you could see the people there in lying prostrate. كَانَّهُمْ أَعْجَازُ نَخْلٍ خَاوِيَةٍ. As if they were trunks of hollow palm trees. فَهَلْ تَرَى لَهُمْ مِنْ بَاقِيَةٍ. So, do you see any remnant of them? وَجَاءَ فِرْعَوْنُ وَمَنْ قَبْلَهُ وَالْمُؤْتَفِكَاتُ بِالْخَاطِئَةِ. In the same way, Fir'aun and those who were before him, and the overturned townships of Sodom and Amorah, they also committed sins. فَعَصَوْا رَسُولَ رَبِّهِمْ. And they disobeyed the messenger of their Lord. فَأَخَذَهُمْ أَخْذَةً رَاوِيَةً. So their Lord seized them with extremely severe seizure of increasing intensity. إِنَّا لَمَّا تَغَلْمَاهُ حَمَلْنَاكُمْ فِي الْجَارِيَةِ. Verily, when the water rose, then we bore you in that floating ark. What do you mean? Your ancestors who were with Nuh, Hazrat Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam, were our ancestors. So as if we were born. لِنَجْعَلَهَا لَكُمْ تَسْكِرَةً وَتَعَيَّهَا غُدْرٌ وَعَيَّةً. So that it becomes an admonition to you and that the retaining ear might retain it. فَإِذَا نُفِقَ فِي السُّورِ. Now when the trumpet is blown, نَفْقَةٌ وَاحِدًا, with a single blast. فَحُمِلَتِ الْأَرْضُ وَالْجِبَالِ. And the earth and the mountains will be lifted. فَدُكَّتَ دَكَّةً وَاحِدًا. And then they will be beaten down and crushed in a single crushing. فَيَوْمَئِذٍ وَقَعَتِ الْوَاقِعَةِ. Then on that day, the event will come to pass. That sure thing to happen will happen. إِذَا وَقَعَتِ الْوَاقِعَةِ. We have read that Surah Al-Waqi'ah. فَيَوْمَئِذٍ وَقَعَتِ الْوَاقِعَةِ. So on that day, that happener would happen. وَانْشَقَّتِ السَّمَاءُ. And the heaven will be split asunder. فَهِيَ يَوْمَئِذٍ وَاهِيَةٌ. On that day it will be weak and torn up. وَالْمَلَكُ عَلَىٰ أَرْجَائِهَا. And the angels will be standing on its borders. فَهِيَ يَوْمَ وَيَحْمِلُ عَرْشَ رَبِّكَ فَوْقَهُمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ سَمَانِيَةٌ. And eight of them, eight angels, will be carrying above them the throne of your Lord. يَوْمَ إِذِنْ تُعْرَضُونَ On that day, you'll be exposed and you'll be brought for the judgment before your Lord. لَا تَخْفَى مِنْكُمْ خَافِيَةً No secret of yours will remain concealed and hidden. Everything will come in the forefront. فَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوتِيَ كِتَابَهُ بِيَمِينِهِ As for those who are given their books in their right hands, فَيَقُولُ He will say, هَاوْ مُقْرَوُ كِتَابِ Come, come, and read my record. Take this, read my record. إِنِّي زَنَنْتُ أَنِّي مُلَاقٍ حِسَابِيَةً I did, surely. I thought that one day I would meet my account. I would meet the results of what I am doing. فَهُوَ فِي شَدْرِ رَادِيَةً So he shall be in a life of bliss. فِي جَنَّةٍ عَالِيَةً In a high and lofty garden. قُطُوفُهَا دَانِيَةً The clusters of its fruit will be at hand. كُلُوا وَاشْرَبُوا It will be said to them, eat and drink pleasantly. كُلُوا وَاشْرَبُوا هَنِيًا بِمَا أَسْلَفْتُمْ فِي الْأَيَّامِ الْخَالِيَةِ For that which you sent on before in days gone by. Your deeds were coming to us and we were writing them and recording them. وَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوتِيَ كِتَابَهُ بِشِمَالِهِ And as for those who will be given their record, their book, in their left hands, فَيَقُولُ So he will say, يَا لَيْتَنِي لَمْ أُوتِيَ كِتَابِيَا Would that I had not been given my record. وَلَمْ أَدْرِ مَا حِسَابِيَا That I had not known what my reckoning and account is. يَا لَيْتَهَا كَانَتِ الْقَاضِيَا Oh, would that death had made an end of me. Would that the death was the end. مَا أَغْنَى عَنِّي مَالِيَا My wealth has not availed me. هَلَكَ عَنِّي سُلْطَانِيَا My authority is gone from me. خُذُوهُ فُغُلُّهُ Then it will be said to the angels, seize him, then fetter him. ثُمَّ جَهِيمَ صَدُّهُ Then cast him into the hellfire. ثُمَّ فِي سِلْسِلَةٍ ذَرْعُهَا سَبْعُونَ ذِرَاعًا فَاسْلُكُوهُ And then in a chain of 70 cubits length, insert him, chain him, bind him. إِنَّهُ كَانَ لَا يُؤْمِنُ بِاللَّهِ الْعَظِيمِ He didn't believe in Allah, the Mighty. وَلَا يَحُضُّ عَلَىٰ طَعَامِ الْمِسْكِينِ And nor did he urge the feeding of the poor and the hungry. فَلَيْسَ لَهُ الْيَوْمَ هَا هُنَا حَمِيمِ So, today, here he doesn't have any friend. وَلَا تَعَامٌ إِلَّا مِنْ غِسْلِينِ Nor anything to eat except foul pus or the wound washings. لَا يَاكُلُهُ إِلَّا الْخَاطِئُونَ Nobody eats this. But the evildoers and eat. فَلَا أُقْسِمُ بِمَّا تُبْصِرُونَ Nay, I swear by that which you see. وَمَا لَا تُبْصِرُونَ And also by that which you don't see. إِنَّهُ لَقَوْلُ رَسُولِ كَرِيمٌ Surely this Quran is the speech of a noble messenger. وَمَا هُوَ بِقَوْلِ شَاعِرٌ It's not the speech of a poet. قَلِيلًا مَّا تُؤْمِنُونَ Little it is that you believe. وَلَا بِقَوْلِ كَاهِنٍ Nor it is the speech of a soothsayer or foreteller. قَلِيلًا مَّا تَذَكَّرُونَ But little are you admonished. تَنزِيلٌ مِنْ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ This is the revelation from the Lord of the worlds. وَلَوْ تَقَوَّلَ عَلَيْنَا بَعْدَ الْأَقَاوِيلِ And if he had invented against us any sayings wrongly, لَأَخَذْنَا مِنْهُ بِالْيَمِينِ We would have seized him by his right hand. ثُمَّ لَقَطَعْنَا مِنْهُ الْوَتِينَ And then we would surely cut his life vein. فَمَا مِنْكُمْ مِنْ أَحَدٍ عَنْهُ عَاجِزِينَ And then none of you would be able to withhold him from us and save him from our punishment. وَإِنَّهُ لَتَذْكِرَةٌ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ And this Quran is a reminding, an admonition for the God-fearing. وَإِنَّا لَنَعْلَمُ أَنَّ مِنْكُمْ مُكَذِّبِينَ And we know, certainly, that some of you are there who belie it. They say, it is wrong. وَإِنَّهُ لَحَسْرَةٌ عَلَى الْكَافِرِينَ And so it is going to be an anguish for the disbelievers. وَإِنَّهُ لَحَقُّ الْيَقِينَ And surely it's the truth of certainty. There's no doubt about this book. فَسَبِّحْ بِسْمِ رَبِّكَ الْعَلِيمِ عَظِيمِ So glorify, O Prophet, the name of your Lord, the Mighty.
سبحان ربي العظيم. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بالآيات والذكر الحكيم.
الله أكبر الله أكبر.
The Islamic Organization of North America, IONA, is an organization dedicated to reviving the Quran into the hearts of Muslims while bringing its message to non-Muslims. The obligations of a Muslim as ordained by the Quran and Sunnah can be understood as having four levels. 1. A Muslim is required to develop real faith and conviction, iman, in one's heart. 2. A Muslim is required to live a life of complete submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 3. A Muslim is required to propagate and disseminate the message of Islam to humanity as a whole. 4. A Muslim is required to try his utmost in establishing the just Islamic order. The first and foremost objective of establishing IONA is to assist the Muslims in North America to uphold and implement these obligations, first on themselves, their families, inform their friends, and then to invite the non-Muslims to Islam. The ultimate goal is to seek Allah's pleasure and salvation in the hereafter. For more information about IONA, please visit us at www.tanzeem.us. You may also email us at info@tanzeem.us or call our toll-free number 866-779-IONA. Join us. Together we can make a difference.